Hello, welcome to the fifth episode of CCR Liberty in Detail. In our last episode, we were talking about BOV, DSV, MAVs, and the options of how to offboard gas on CCR Liberty. In this episode, we'll be talking about ADVs, what they are, and what options you can choose with your Liberty configuration. ADV stands for automatic diluent valve. So when the diver is descending, the surrounding pressure is increasing, which compresses the gas inside of the loop. And then if no gas is injected into the loop, with increasing depth, the loop would get so compressed that it would not allow the diver to take a breath. And this is what the DSV stops from happening. The DSV is a valve which injects gas from our diluent cylinder into our loop to keep pressure within it so the diver can keep breathing. The ADV is located on the inhaling side of the loop. The ADVs have different constructions as well as the options of where they can be placed, which affects their performance. As you can see, here we have quite a few options that the Liberty can come with. And some of them you can choose which you would like to have with your configuration. And this is what we're going to have a look at now. The first ADV that we're going to have a look at is mechanical ADV. This ADV comes with a front mounted counterlung version of the unit, and it's placed here. This is the most basic type of ADV that the unit comes with. The way this ADV works is that when the volume starts decreasing within the counterlung, the side of the counterlung starts pressing onto the ADV, and that pushes onto a lever that is inside that is eventually pushing onto a valve which is within the ADV, allowing it to open the diluent injection into the lung. This ADV comes with a shut-off valve which can be easily turned off by pushing this part in to position closed, and this will turn the ADV off in the situations where you do not want the ADV to fire automatically and you wish to control the unit yourself. The next ADV that we're going to have a look at is a membrane ADV. This ADV is also suited for a front mounted counterlung unit and it's easily replaceable. So you can select which type of an ADV you would like to have just by lining up the markers there. ADV is locked in a position and it can be used. You can select this ADV, this type of an ADV with your configuration in our configurator. This is a more precise and sensitive type of an ADV. The way this works, it's a pretty much simplified second stage regulator that is inside. It only contains few parts, so it's very simple but very effective. You can also use this ADV manually just by pressing the membrane here and manually add the diluent into the counterlung. This ADV also comes with a shutoff valve as well as the mechanical ADV. The next ADV that we're going to have a look at is a T-piece ADV. This ADV can be used on a front mounted counterlung version and it can also be used on a back mounted counterlung version. The construction of this membrane ADV is exactly the same as this one, simplified second stage regulator pretty much, but the position is different. The ADV is located on your shoulder where it changes the properties of how it behaves by its location. This position works probably the best and it has the most precise way of adding the gas. And it is also one of the most popular types of ADVs that the customers usually choose in their configuration. It also comes with a shutoff valve, same type as these units, and it can be easily turned on and off just by pulling on the lever. The next ADV that we're going to have a look at is a direct membrane ADV. As you can see, it looks very similar to the T-piece ADV. It's just not in the T-piece, it is direct. The way it is this way is that it's mainly designed for the side mount unit. In standard configuration, it does not come with shutoff valve. The reason behind that is that if the side mount rebreather is used as a bailout rebreather, we do not want the shutoff valve to be accidentally turned on, therefore the ADV to be shut off. If the customer decides to do go with the shutoff valve, it can be selected in the configurator, but the diver needs to be aware of its function. Again, as well as the previous membrane ADVs, the inner construction is exactly the same as the other ones, which is a simplified second stage regulator, and it also can be manually activated by pressing the membrane here. The last ADV option that we're going to have a look at is having your ADV mounted as a part of your BOV. This configuration can be used with back-mounted units, and it doesn't matter whether you're using back-mounted counterlungs or front-mounted counterlungs. If your BOV doesn't have the ADV, it can be easily changed to ADV version just by replacing the barrel inside. The way you operate the ADV is that in this position, we're at open circuit. In this position, the ADV is turned off. Over here, we're at open circuit again. In this position, we're at closed circuit with the ADV on. The threshold of the function of the ADV can be adjusted just by using a flathead screwdriver. You just basically put it through there. There is a flathead screw, and you can adjust the tension of the threshold of the ADV. This ADV is more of a streamlined function if you do not wish to have any other elements such as T-piece ADV on your shoulder, and makes everything a lot more streamlined. All these ADVs are great and they all work brilliantly. I personally use the T-piece ADV with BOV without an ADV in a back-mounted counterlung configuration, but everybody's different and people can choose what type of ADV they would like to have and that they would prefer to be using with their own configuration based on their preference. So today we've had a look at how the ADVs work, what they are, and which one would be the most suitable for you. I hope that this has helped you to pick the right one for you, and thank you for watching today's episode. And as always, for more information, please visit our webpage at divesoft.com, where you can find our configurator, where you can have a play and configure the unit based on your desired preference. And if you have any further questions, please email us at info@divesoft.com. Thank you, and I will see you next time.